Hello, everyone. Nice to see you again. I will read you a book on Eastern philosophies for a minute before you go to sleep. And then, I hope you have a good night's sleep with the sound of rain continuing. Today, I will read Myeongsimbogam, Chapter 20, Conflicting Feelings Between Parents and Children. When a child scolds me, I feel joy in my heart. But when my father and mother scold me and become angry, I do not feel good in my heart. One is happy and the other is not. How can the feelings toward children and the feelings toward parents be so different? I advise you that when you are scolded by a parent, you do it just as you would when you are scolded by your own child. Young children say many things, but you don't always hate hearing them. And even if their parents say something once, they nag it a lot. Parents do this not because they care in vain, but because they are worried. There is a lot to know in this long period of time, even with gray hair. I advise you to respect and follow the words of old people and not to argue about length or shortness with a mouth that smells like milk. Dirty things like a child's urine and excrement do not cause any aversion in your heart, but the tears and saliva dripping from an old parent are something you hate and dislike. Where did a body as tall as 6 feet come from? Your body is made up of your father's essence and your mother's blood. I advise you to treat aging people with respect. When he was young, he watched over you and worked hard until your bones were worn out. I see you go into the store early in the morning and buy things, but I don't hear that you give it to your parents, but rather you give it to your children. If the child is full before the parent has even chewed yet, the child's heart will not be able to compare to the pleasure of the parent's heart. I advise you to spend a lot of money to buy bread and take care of your old parents, as they only have a short time left to live. The stores that sell medicine in the market only have medicine to make children gain weight, but not medicine to make parents strong. For what reason are you looking at these two things? The child also gets sick and the parents also get sick. So curing a child's illness cannot be compared to curing a parent's illness. Even if you cut off your leg, this is your parent's flesh. So I advise you to quickly save the lives of both your parents. When you are rich and noble, it is easy to support your parents, but the parents always feel sorry. When you are poor and lowly, it is difficult to raise a child, but the child does not suffer from hunger and cold. Having one heart and two ways, serving a child is not like serving a father. I advise you to raise children like two parents, and do not put off any work just because the family is not wealthy. There are only two people to support the parents, but they always quarrel with their brothers. And although there are 10 people to raise the children, you take care of them all alone. Parents always ask if their child is full and warm, but hunger and cold are not in their hearts. I advise you to do your best to support your parents, at first. Your clothes and food were taken from you. A father has 10 minutes of kindness, but you do not think of his grace. A child is 1 minute of filial piety, but you go out and make his name known. He is dark when dealing with parents, but bright when dealing with children. Who knows Godang's heart in raising children? I advise you not to believe in the filial piety of children. You are the father of your children, and your son is yourself. I will meet you in the next chapter. And now, I wish you a peaceful healing time with the sound of rain. May your heart be filled with love each and every day. You are someone who loves yourself.